I started with helping out my father, who started the business in 1972, doing just part-time excavating work. At the time, he had two other jobs. He got to the point where he got more involved with the business and decided to quit the other jobs and to go into business for himself. I took the business over, and my father helped me for a while, and then he wanted to take time off. And being out there on the job yourself, thinking, how am I going to get this done? Back then, we didn't have level lasers. We had an old transit and a stick, and propping the stick up against a piece of equipment and running and looking through the old transit and then running back. That's like how much we have progressed over the years. The technology has really changed.
I went to school for civil engineering, so that's definitely helped me in being able to understand the plan side of things for all the commercial projects. So just the overall knowledge that I've had over the years of being in the field, doing the work prior to that, doing all the residential work, has helped me kind of gain a knowledge on both sides of things. And when I came back and started working in 2009, we kind of started to switch more and do a little bit more of the commercial work. It's a new avenue that we hadn't went into before. And since I've been here, we've grown and kind of switched where a majority of our work now is in the commercial side of things, from full service site development, start to finish, everything from the stormwater to getting the stone prepped and doing the paving at the end. But with our background in the residential side of things, we do a lot of fine grading, a lot of projects where you're not relying just on the GPS. So you got to be able to do a lot of work that is more tedious work. So I think with that background and that tedious residential work, it allows us to be able to create a much nicer product, even on the commercial side of things, because the employees are so used to what's required. Switching from not having any sort of lasers when you started to integrating to using just the rotary laser to then kind of implementing maybe we had put the grade control eyes on the sides of our booms of our excavators, and then kind of progressing the same way with dozers to having your eye to switching to the full automatics on our machines, on our dozers and excavators, has definitely been a game changer for us.
Our strength I believe is we're very particular in the job that we do for people. All of our jobs, we do very low advertising. Most of it is word of mouth. And that has kept us in business over all the years, 40 years, even during the slow times. So I think, you know, being there for people when they need us, and never turning a job down, doing anything that we could possibly do, we did. And doing the job the right way. As I used to tell my operators, you're almost like an artist when you're grading. You start out with something very rough and you get to see the project completed to where it's fine graded, the portrait's finished. That's what I like to see. We treat our employees as almost like a family. I'm out on the job site, many times it's one-on-one with them. Many times I'm down in the ditch, I'm carrying pipe, I'm with the laborers. And I think that means a lot to them. It's like, he's just not standing there watching us. He's one of us.
We have a fairly young staff, so I feel like we all kind of are at this stage of the young families. So I think our work hours, we try to keep those. We do work some longer hours in the summer, but we try to keep our work hours Monday through Friday. Try to keep the weekend work to minimal, try to reward them, and we do have company holiday parties and stuff. It's the whole family's involved. It's not just the employee and a spouse or something. So we want to make sure that they keep their families involved the whole time.